So at the end of the workout, and everything went decent today. We're deloading. So it's the fifth week. We're scaling back. I'm actually going to take it slow for the next 2 weeks. I think it's time to like scale it back a little bit. My body was like getting wrecked in the end of the last lot. I think it's just going to be smarter on my end, knowing that I'm hitting and potentially I'm intentionally going to hit heavier loads by week four. Week three is going to be relatively heavy, but it should still be a decent number. I had my call with Marcellus last Friday, and you know, we tweaked some things in the program that we think are going to be beneficial going forward. What we did last block was really, really great. Now we're just managing like the stress of it and loads and things like that. We're going back to conventional, which conventional worked for me really well. We're still keeping pauses in because those have been great for me. My positioning has been great on that, and it helps me be patient regardless of whether I want to or not. It forces me to be patient. And I'm keeping my lifters on with a high bar squat. Someone commented on my post of like, why was I switching back and forth? Because I haven't really explained that. I just kind of started doing it. But I was experimenting with it, and you know, it's been working. June is my next meet. That's Nationals. I'll be competing in 90 kg and the USAPL. So that's gonna be real cool. Becca's got her meet coming up March 6th, and that is at the Arnold's. So we're preparing for that for her. And you know, my training's like important, of course, but Becca's probably gonna be in the forefront going forward. Just like she needs the most attention right now. So I'm gonna, you know, try to focus a little bit more on that.
Love you.
And so it is, damn, what day is it? Today's Wednesday. I am off to crunch. Wednesday's usually a rest day for me, but yesterday I made it a rest day because I needed to get some content out and had a bunch of stuff to do. So I'm headed to crunch and I'm going to do my bench session there since it is a, damn, I didn't even lock my door last night. That's crazy. So I'm gonna go in now. It's about 1 o'clock or so. Knockout bench. We'll probably do something in the mid 300s.
What's happening, everyone? Welcome back to another how-to video. In this video, I get to show you guys how to elevate your ground turkey game. This time with turkey meatballs.
All right, I got my fries. I realized I didn't really eat much carbs today, and it's time to squat. So Bojangles only has small and large. They don't have a medium, so I had to get a large fry. I ain't mad. And they hot. And this Bojangles just opened up right beside my crib. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, I ain't mad.
I got hey. Caffeine in me. What it is, y'all?
Hey, what it is?
Hey,
it's finally showed up, bro.
It's Mr. Wake Your Punk Ass Up, aka Mr. Rise and Crime.
Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good. Oh, I guess my headphones aren't working. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, perfect.
When did you start powerlifting?
Started powerlifting training in November of 2016.
Okay, were you in high school?
No, so I'm 31.
You know, I'm 56 years old.
Damn!
I'm sorry.
We'll take a poll on how you meant it.
All right, so that was kind of weird. It was super fast. So what you guys just saw was I had a call with North Carolina Amateur Sports. Honestly, I didn't know what it was about. I got emailed. The homie Nick Hammer hooked me up. He was like, hey, you know, the North Carolina Amateur Sports wants to do an article on, you know, an athlete. And, you know, you got brought up. Would you be willing? And I was like, yeah, that's fine. You know, just shoot them over my email. They linked up and, you know, we got on this call. And it wasn't really prepared well. And Mia, the lady, she was good. She said that, you know, this was, you know, she was an intern for North Carolina Sports. And, you know, all she knew was that I powerlift. You know, she didn't know anything about the sport. And we didn't have time for me to like divulge everything I knew about the sport, right? You know, like how powerlifting works, you know, she kept asking like, was I competing this year or that I'm not competing this year? Or if I like, and I was trying to explain like, you know, powerlifting is a constant thing. You know, like we're active members, unless we literally just don't compete anymore, but we're active members, right? And, you know, like just trying to have her understood that was kind of like rough, which I mean, it is what it is. I was just like, no, I'm an active member. I compete and I can compete whenever I feel like competing. But my next meet isn't until this date. And then like, for some reason, I guess she forgot I said that. So she asked if I was competing this year and I was like, I'm an active member. Yes, I'm. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. But you know, there was only like a couple of questions. It wasn't that many. And it was just kind of like, what got you into the sport, which brings up a backstory. And that wasn't like very long. I tried to like shorten it down, you know. Mentioned my college background, played college football for 4 years, was on a scholarship, played at Chuan. You know, she's not from this area, so she didn't really know where all this stuff was, so I had to explain that. And it was just a lot of information all over the place. Basically, it was unorganized, and there was like maybe three or four questions she was meant to ask, but it wasn't more of a conversation. It was like, these are the questions. It was me giving like very blunt answers to them, but no elaborate storyline. So that was kind of like, there's no story here. There's no like inspiration here. You know, I mean, it is within me, but it wasn't like, I don't know. It didn't feel organic. It felt like, all right, I have to do this. We need an athlete. And so I'm like, it's cool, but I wish it was a little bit more engaging. I guess that's what I'm going for. I think they asked me like what powerlifters did I look up to and aspire to be like? And I was like, nobody. Like there's nobody in powerlifting I look up to and want to aspire to be like. There's powerlifters I admire from afar, but I was like, I got into sport so late. I got into sport when I was 25 years old, turning 26, like a month later, you know, that, you know, I didn't really know the legends growing up. I didn't, like, I know them now, but I didn't know them then. So I admire them from afar, but it wasn't like, I was like, oh my God, that's that person. That's that person. The only person I've ever done that to in terms of like knowing that their legendary status, you know, was Jen Thompson. But you know, like other than that, it wasn't really anyone else. But now, you know, I've kind of grown to like appreciate what everyone can bring to the sport and what people are doing for their sport. I definitely do appreciate that, but that would take more time for me to like sit down and digest and actually think about versus like hopping on a call, you know, not knowing what I was going to be asked and being asked a bunch of, you know, random questions, I guess. I mean, I know that's usually how it goes, but this was just kind of like not well prepared. So, I mean, it is what it is, but it was cool that, you know, I'm getting a piece written about me. I just wish it was more in depth.
Good morning. Oh my gosh. No. Hi. Hey, fans.
I'm recording this entire segment. I just wanted to record this one piece because Nora's back. I get so excited.
We're Woo. Back. Should I show? Here's Dobie chilling at the pool.
Yeah.
Fuck. I don't know what that was. What's up? What's up? Today's Monday. You know what that means? Got squats and conventional deadlifts. I'm excited because I feel like I can just recover a little bit more. Could I do the bow chicken sandwich meal?
The combo
just
sandwich?
The combo.
Okay, bow chicken sandwich combo, soda, drink.
Let's do fries and diet Pepsi.
Anything else?
That'll be it. Thank you. Thank you.
Have a good day.
You too. Alright, so I'm looking back just to make sure the person's not looking at me, but that woman looked at me up and down. But one of those, like, she took my car, and when she handed it back, she like handed it, and like as I grabbed it, she was like, "Have a good day," and I was just like, "Okay." So I just wanted my chicken, my fries, not my chicken. Like the chicken I'm gonna eat still, but the fries is what I wanted. Justin's back. I was just telling, you know, YouTube that Jess came back to town, you know what I mean? Had to bless us with a presence in these beautiful squats.
Oh my god, these beautiful squats, what the fuck you mean?
The toes! Oh my god.
All the way up. Good. Oh. Yeah.
That is the better good.
All right.
Oh, come on,
now. What?
When you don't see the camera for it.
I'm doing something uncharacteristic like of me, kind of, sort of, not really. I'm headed to Spider today, Sunday. Usually wait till Monday to do my squats and deadlifts and all that fun stuff, but today's Sunday, I'm gonna go ahead and get it. You know, it was a good crew here last night. I'm sure there'll some of those people will be here tomorrow to train, or today to train, and I'm just gonna go ahead and knock out my squat and deadlift today and do all my accessories. Just knock out my Monday workout today on Sunday. I have more time to do it today. I have a lot of work to do today as well too, but anyway, I think I'm gonna go anywhere between 684 to 705 for a double today. We'll see what happens. We'll see what's in the tank and we'll just let it go from there.
Get out here, man, hold on. Cheers. Oh, dad, you got
I had to back up, bro. Hey, it's today Sunday, bro. We about to get it. I'm lifting with Dom today.
Yes,
I'm
sir.
Squatting with the homie because he's going to 600 today and I'm going a little heavier. You going 600 for a dub? You got dubs?
I do got dubs.
What you got?
I got a 6 though.
I got a 6'2", I think.
I bet.
Actually, no, hold on. We'll pause for a second. I got dubs. I got a single on deads. All right, I got a RPE 7. You got a 6.
Yeah.
So basically, whatever Dom does, whatever I do, not Dom, whatever I do, Dom has to do 100 pounds less. So I'm going 705 today. So he has 606.
606.
For a dub.
700 for a dub?
705 for a dub.
Ooh, on Sunday? Hold on, first of all, white trainer on Sunday because we'll be training tomorrow.
Yeah, I mentioned that
earlier?
Yeah, in the video. I was just saying, like, I had a lot of stuff to do. I was saying I already had a lot to do tomorrow.
Yeah.
Today's one of those days where there's a lot of people to meet. Oh, yesterday was one of those days, a lot of people to meet. Those people tend to come and train on Sunday, and I'm always missing out. So I don't get to like ever train with those people or my friends. And a lot of them are like traveling from like Charlotte and other places. So
it's gonna be today.
I always miss it. So I'm like, you know what? Let me just go in, knock it out. One day doesn't change. I'm used to training at 6 p.m. on Mondays. My body just used
it. It's about the experience today.
Mm-hmm.
I've never trained with you on Monday. Ever.
Yes.
I never see him on the primary day.
But also I get to train with someone like with squatting, right? So the pace is gonna be different. It's gonna be fun. But you know, I just really, really, really want to like be in this environment today. Like Monday is cool, but then like being in an environment where people don't ever get to see me lift except for on social media.
Probably wild.
It's gonna be fun, you know.
That'd be crazy.
If they come, cool. If they don't, that's fine too. I'm still training with my homie. You know what I mean?
Cool.
Hey.
This is for Hot 9-7. This is for Clue, for Cali, for the veterans. This is just piling. This is Jeff from Auto 2, Norman and Kylie.
Come on.
Let's go! Are you gonna pick it up?
No.
Yesterday's price is not today's price.
But only I can really have a slow fight. Detroit nigga challenge, what you know like? If your bitch nigga step it up, go slide. Missy was our only misdemeanor. My tunnel
bitch, oh yeah. Come on.
You order Diet Coke, that's a joke, right? Wish me luck,
Yeah.
Let's go. Turn us up.
So, what you guys just saw was Dom and I, we were competing back to back. You know, I mean, I don't really train here on Sundays, and also I don't really get an opportunity to train with Dom. So we had an opportunity to actually like train together. And then our dads were kind of like tit for tat. So he had a double, I had a single for dads, and I'm doing conventional. So I was joking saying conventional was easy. He was like, all right, bet, I'm gonna do whatever you do, but for a double. And he did that shit, you know what I mean? Like, which was really dope. And the energy was just something that I like love. You know, sometimes I need that. So he did a 606 for a double, and I did 606 for a single. So since he did it for a double, I'm gonna go up a little bit more. Just try to like combat that. So I'm going 628 for a single. We'll see how that moves. I just incorporated deadlifts, conventional deadlifts back into my program recently. So it's only week three of conventional pulls. So we'll see what we got today. 606 moved. I should probably cap it there, but since Dom did 606 for a dub, I can't let him trump me. But that's a little ego, but also that's competitiveness, and I love it. So we'll go ahead and hit this real quick.
Put that slack out, boy.
Sitting here at Crunch. So it's me waving at Becca. She's working, she's over there.
Yeah, there she is.
It's the glasses, I saw it. But I had a really, really great training session. Really fun, probably the most fun, the most chill, the most laid-back session I've had in forever. Usually I'm super serious on my Monday nights because it's busy. I'm just trying to get in, knock my squats out, get to my deadlifts. I'm not really talkative until after my squats, but today I was just like chilling with Dom, just talking the entire time, just getting to work in, and we had a really great day, you know. The Charlotte crew came down. I mean, they had, the Oak City was Saturday, so I'm sure they all like, kind of stayed around, and then they all came in and trained. So it was like a lot of good energy, a lot of good vibes, but it was busy, but it wasn't like annoying busy. It was like busy, but everyone was working busy, and I enjoyed that too. So shout out to the crews. Shout out to all y'all for being down here and just killing it. I ate Chipotle. I'm like tired. I don't know what happened, but it feels like I got hit by like a bus in terms of like I'm tired, I'm sleepy. But I'm gonna go ahead and sit in the sauna. I was gonna do some cardio, but I'm just gonna sit in the sauna, relax a bit, and that's really it. But you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna end this video here. Really appreciate you guys' support. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.
Yesterday's price is not today's price.